Big Cat Den, ex Pastor Reacts. We got to tell that story sometime. But all right, asking Alexandria is what they're here for.
Yeah.
They don't care. They don't want what we
they
want.
Don't want. Yeah, we don't want. Yeah.
They don't want what we want, and they don't care.
Yep.
Never heard this one before. Looking forward to it. I like the title already. What age were you when you realized this?
Oh, man. Probably the last couple of years.
Oh, really?
Yeah. I'm a lot younger than you.
Hmm.
When did you find out?
Well, it depends who the they is.
No, I was thinking government.
Oh.
What were you thinking of? Parents?
Oh, maybe teachers.
Yeah. I didn't think about that. I just went along.
But they kind of, some of them do.
I guess I did find out in college.
Oh.
Yeah. I had one professor. Oh. That stood up
against. Is it a big scam? Is that what we're saying? Is the whole thing's a big scam? Just go to Alaska and just build your cabin?
I would survive.
So it's your fears that's stopping you?
No, I just want to be able to enjoy life. What? That's like right now. Everything's closed. No concerts or anything.
I mean, we're not locked down, but the government in Michigan has no indoor dining, no bars, no concerts.
Yeah, no sporting events.
Nothing that Big Cat spent the whole summer last year doing has been open, right? Pretty much.
Two summers now. Because there's nothing this year. Yeah, because I saw this band several times last year. I dragged all my friends to see them.
I'm probably losing people. Here we go.
Sanctuary, not a prison. There's something strange going on in this house. It's like I'm pushing all these buttons.
So we were doing your Spotify year in review.
Yeah.
And this was your number one song, right?
Yep.
So you've listened to this song more than any other song?
Apparently.
This year?
Yep.
Why?
I think because it started with the lockdowns, like just like resonating with me. You know, like I said, like in the song, this just came out the other day in the news, but like watching you from their castle, or and it seemed like with China, they're watching. I can't remember the news story. I'm getting it wrong, so I'm not gonna say it. But yeah, it's just you seem about everything that's happening in the government right now. Like, obviously, people they want to work and they can't in our state, anyways. Like small businesses, they're gonna shut down.
Yeah.
This album came out right at the start of COVID for us, like March or April.
Okay.
So, just remember, like, when everything, like, when the government shut down Sarah Niles, when we were locked down, we couldn't go to the paint aisle, we couldn't go to the seeds to get seeds,
fishing. I think we might have been the only state in the United States where they literally, so the governor ordered that certain businesses could stay open, which she called essential, but then she also said what was essential at the essential businesses.
Yeah.
So they had like tape over certain aisles in the stores.
I think car seats were one of them, even like car seat aisles. Like, it was nuts. Yeah.
But during that time, of course, you could go on Amazon and order whatever you wanted.
Yeah, weird.
So, I like the what's happening musically.
Yeah.
With this.
This is a new style of music for them. They want. Go ahead.
I was just gonna say, and the vibe is, you know how sometimes I get a little bit overwhelmed when the vibe is like too negative.
Yeah.
It's not.
No.
I think they find a good balance of rage.
This is a great album.
Do you still get hair standing up on the back of your neck?
Nah, no, not really.
What do you get when you get rage?
Probably silent, like.
Oh, but what do you get that's probably physiological?
Probably just sick to my stomach.
Like, is it like an instant, like a a shot?
Yep. Adrenaline, you know, like, yeah.
That's what I'm saying. What does the adrenaline feel like for you?
Oh, just...
Is it like a squirt?
No, it's like it's full on. I had adrenaline rush this summer and something I was doing. And then I was like talking to somebody, man, I miss that feeling. And then I got home and I crashed because that rush was over.
Okay.
So...
See, I get like it feels like a something has been injected into my heart.
Yeah.
Like a pump down. And then I get that, and then if it's like a verbal thing, I get like a momentary blind, like very momentary, but it'll be like almost like a movie or something.
Kind of get out of your body, like.
This one is more like I can't see for just a
second,
split second. It feels like somebody just floored the gas, and I'm like, and then I gotta, like, as a male. A white male in 2020, you have to tread so lightly in every interaction and conversation. And
do you feel like you black out almost? No,
I can see why. I can see why people call it blacking out.
Yeah.
But see, what I don't know is if the people that black out and have, like, I would say I have internalization of anger issues, but I don't have explosive anger.
Yeah, same. Yeah.
But would the people that have the explosive anger and say they black out when they got angry, are they talking about like they have that flash, but it's longer and they do something? I mean,
yeah.
It's possible that it might be, they might do brain scans of people that have anger disorder and find out that they actually are disconnected from their like their thinking abilities like during those times?
Lobe, yeah.
Yeah. So should they be held accountable? I mean, what's the solution for someone like that? Not good.
Nope.
It's not headed in a good direction. If you think about the more research they do on us and what we're likely to do in the future, and the way that our governments are approaching, I'll call it anticipatory behaviors, it's not looking good. In fact, I just saw Biden, he got in trouble because he was on a conference call and he said, you know, I can't just ban assault rifles by executive order my first day. The assault rifles. Oh, they're talking about gun control. We just lost some subscribers.
Nice.
So anyway, the instincts are for restricting human behaviors.
That's what this song's all about, yeah.
And when you restrict human behaviors, the war on drugs taught us that you create an underground,
yeah,
which eventually becomes, if it's an instinctual thing that you're trying to suppress, the underground eventually becomes more powerful,
yeah,
and consumes the system. But usually, you know, maybe thousands or millions of lives are lost by that point. Yeah. It's not heading in a good direction, folks. Now, I think the question is, do you want to be a part of it? Or withdraw from it? Engage with it? And we're kind of kicking the tires on it. I mean, by that I mean we're somewhat engaged with these videos, but we're not doing like the full on, you know, every night, like bringing you what's happening.
Because
that's not what this show's about. This show's about the music, but the music is, it's like if you have a pimple, the stuff that's coming out of the pimple,
yeah,
that's what the music is to me.
Oh, yeah.
It's kind of like the...
I think we're going to see more of that.
Yeah, oh yeah.
I think, I mean, the last band we did, Bring Me the Horizon, with the song Obey.
Mm-hmm.
This band, I mean...
And we're seeing a lot more civil disobedience and a lot more people calling BS on the BS.
Mm-hmm.
So... thanks for bringing us that song. Thanks for subscribing to the channel. We're going to be a little bit more
engaged.
Consistent.
Yeah.
Not like an every week video or anything, but we're trying to get a little bit more of a pattern.
Yeah.
So thanks, everybody.
Thanks, guys.